All right, Brendan Taylor here, and I'm with Rafael Ramos, legend in boxing, done, you know, traveled the world and did many things. Rafa, tell people about your background, you know, where you were born, just a little bit about yourself.
I was born in New York City in the village. My grandmother, my father, he could not take care of me when I was a kid. My grandmother came from Puerto Rico, almost 6 months. He take me to Puerto Rico from Quebradilla. It's a little town, you know. It's a town. He's never see a trainer over there. Only a town only play basketball over there. And my grandfather, he used to be, he made the first team of basketball in Quebradilla, Marco Star Gym, a Marco Star
basketball,
yeah. Yeah, All-Star, yeah.
So there wasn't really no boxing over there?
Never.
So how did you find boxing?
And I started, you know, training martial art because when I was in the school, in elementary school, this guy, Alfredo Vargas, this teacher, he used to tell him that Alfredo to fight with me all the time. And the guy, he beat me up all the time. And I said, man, I need to learn something. So I talked to another great guy, you know, he passed away, you know. I met Kike Castillo, and he told me, oh man, you want to learn, man. He said, school here, you can come and learn Shaolin Kempo, you know, karate. So I said, man, I would like to learn because this guy, he been abusing me all the time. He been beating me, you know. And I said, I'll take it to my teacher, Felipe Rivera and Jose Martinez. That's when I started training Shaolin Kempo and Jichuan Kung Fu.
Okay, and then that led to you becoming, how did that lead to you becoming, you know, finding boxing?
I started training Jichuan Kung Fu with Oscar Cañar, one of the masters in Puerto Rico, and Jose Martinez, another master, and I went represent Puerto Rico in the World Kung Fu tournaments in Republica Dominican. I won a bronze medal over there, represent, you know, and then I fight a lot of tournaments. I'm 10-0. I never lost a tournament. And from there, I continued my craft. I went to train boxing in Levittown, with Edwin Rosario. And I sparred with him. I sparred with a lot of fighters over there. And I continued, you know, training, you know, until I went emigrate to the States, you know, in 1981.
Yeah. Yeah, and you around like 1976, you had a chance to be a sparring partner, right? That's how you kind of
came. Yeah. With Rosario and Felipe Pintola, sparred with him too. And a lot of fighters, you know, Manny Siakaga, Laro Medina, and Levittown, boxing club.
Mm-hmm. And then like what, 1981, you went to New York, right?
Yes.
And that's where you met...
I met another great teacher, David Claudio. He used to train kickboxing. He used to be a state champion in kickboxing. And then I met Freddie Corriton, one of the other trainers. And I started training in his school.
Okay. Okay, so after training under the great Customato, you went back to your roots and you kind of picked up another form of fighting. Can you talk to people about that?
Oh, yes. I trained in the aging school of Wing Chun with Sonny Whitmore. The Grandmaster William Chung in Queens, New York.
Okay. And what was that like?
Oh, that was great for me. Because I said, man, this town, he got a lot of things, you know, I need to learn. Because I'm very open-minded person as a trainer. I don't stuck in one thing, you know?
Yeah. What did that do for you mentally as someone who's in martial arts?
He gave me in the high level. As a trainer of boxing and Wing Chun trainer, a martial artist.
Yeah, and how did his teachings at the school of Wing Chun, how has it helped you now as a guy who, you know, teaches boxing?
Oh, he put me together, everything together, all the puzzles together, and elevate me to another high level.
Okay, so after you picked up Wing Chun, what was next for you? What did you do?
Oh, the next move I got after I learned Wing Chun with Sonny Whitmore and the Grand Master, I got the opportunity in 1997 to move to Grand Rapids, Michigan. And Nate Jones see me the way I train, and he liked the way I train. He said, Rafi, I would like you to be my head trainer.
Yeah, and that's, and under Nate Jones, you had a chance to meet Floyd Mayweather Jr., who we all know now.
Yeah, both, the father, senior, and his son.
Mm-hmm. And what was that like, having them in the gym every day?
Oh, that was good. That was good, real good.
What were some things you noticed about Floyd early on, Floyd Jr.?
When I was training Nate Jones, he all the time, he come to Grand Rapids and visit Nate Jones, because both went to the Olympics in 1996 in Atlanta. And he had me question, oh, how I can beat this fighter? You know, because he would try to see I know about boxing. Floyd is the type of person, he's very smart. He testing you to see you know about, you know, what you're talking about boxing.
Yeah, so he was very like, he analyzed everything. He kind of studied everybody.
Yes.
And, you know, as far as not just how he thought in the ring or outside the ring, as a fighter, his talent, could you talk about the talent you saw back then, Floyd Jr.?
Man, he's the best. That guy is the best. He's at another level.
What makes him another level above everybody else?
Man, he got everything. He's a completed fighter. He got full work. He got the defense is good. And his punch is super fast. Mm. And Floyd is the type of the fighter he like to think. It's like you play chess. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. When you were in the gym all those years with him, did he ever spar anybody? Were there any sparring sessions you saw from him where you were just like, wow, like this guy?
Yeah, and one time he come to the gym in Grand Rapids. David Parker, he got a gym over there. He used to be one of his coach.
Mm.
And I went there, he's probably another kid he trained, Alex Sepulveda, Papito, and Floyd sparring with them and everything.
Yeah. You told me the other day that you guys have a great relationship, right? Like to this day, I know you train fighters at his gym. Why is your guys' relationship so good?
Because I see Floyd, he got a good heart, man. Floyd, he like to help people. I love Floyd as a person.
What do you rank him among the best fighters of all time?
He's the number one.
He's number one?
Mm-hmm.
Why number one?
Because he's a completed fighter.
Okay.
He never take punches. And that's what a fighter is. Take hit and don't get hit.
And he's done that pretty much as good as anybody?
Yes.
Alright. Okay, so being that you were in the gym, you know, and you got to see Customato, you saw Mike Tyson, can you tell me about their relationship?
He's like a father and son. He's teaching him the technique, how he can deal with people in general in life, you know? And I saw it all the time with him, with Mike.
Yeah, when Cus passed away, could you sense a change in Mike Tyson?
Yeah, he hurt him a lot, man, because that lost his father.
Yeah.
And his mentor.
Do you feel like if Cus had a chance to live longer into Mike's career, like more of Mike's career, do you think Mike probably would have had a better career, maybe solidified his spot as the greatest heavyweight of all time?
Cus would be alive and he don't die. Mike Tyson, he retired undefeated. Nobody can beat him.
Why do you feel that way?
Because the technique, man. It's not too many people, man. This guy, Cus D'Amato, is a master. He created his own system. That's a system of fighting, pickup style. It's like the Wing Chun and boxing, like me. And Bruce Lee, he created his own style, Jeet Kune Do.
Yeah, and then Cus seemed to just know how to get the best out of Mike. Nobody really could do that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you incorporated Wing Chun and boxing together. First of all, for those people out there who don't know what Wing Chun is, could you explain to them what Wing Chun is?
Wing Chun is an art. It hit at the same time. A lot of people just blocking. The Wing Chun don't call him blocking, it's called cover. And hit, you know, with bad intention, he hurt you. So I combine the Wing Chun with boxing because both comparable. And it's a lot of angles. And the Wing Chun alone, traditional Wing Chun. It's two Wing Chun.
Mm-hmm.
It's modified and traditional. I learned traditional.
Yeah, and like what? How is it different from just your regular boxing?
Oh, it's because he put the regular boxing. Arlen the best boxing. Arlen with Costa Amaro is the greatest trainers in the world, you know. And then I combined with William Chung, and Sonny Whitmore, one of my teachers, he teach me the traditional Wing Chun.
Yeah. How is Wing Chun relevant to boxing? Like why what's the whole point of forming it together? Why is it relevant?
Wing Chun, he got a lot of angles and a lot of covers. So sometimes I see Floyd using some couple of technique.
Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah. So you can use it in Wing Chun, the same thing. And I see the other part of boxing. He got the same angles, you know what I mean? So that's why I combine peekaboo Wing Chun boxing.
So if you were teaching like a boxer some, you know, boxing and Wing Chun together, what do you feel it would accomplish as opposed to like just regular boxing?
Oh, I made the guy a champion because it's different, you know, total different than the regular boxing.
Yeah.
All the difference is a lot of angles, fighting in the blind side. I hit you, you cannot hit me.
So it's basically positioning. It's all about the positioning.
Yeah, positioning and a lot of defense, you know.
So you're saying like if a fighter trains the Wing Chun and boxing together and they've mastered it, they're going to always have an advantage in positioning.
Yeah.
And that they'll probably become like world champions, you think. Okay, so that's good to know. All right. So you're in Las Vegas training at the Mayweather Boxing Club. How did you wind up in Las Vegas?
I was moved to Puerto Rico in 2007 to assist my mom. She was sick. And one day I called, in 2009, I called Floyd Senior, because that's like my best friend. And he said, motherfucker, come here, man. Where you do fucking Puerto Rico? There's no fighters there. I said, okay, Floyd, let me sell everything. I go over there, okay? I promise.
Yeah, and then
I came here.
How you like it?
And then when I came here, one day I went to the gym, and Floyd the champ, he started laughing. When he see me, he do like this to me, hey man, like good. So from there I just started working with the fighter. Then my first fighter I started working is Jantua, Kofi Jantua.
Kofi Jantua, yeah. And he had that vicious knockout over, I can't remember right now, I think it was Rubio?
Rubio.
Yeah. And how you like it? How you like training fighters here in Vegas?
Oh, I love it. That's my passion, train the fighters.
Yeah. All right, Rafa. So I want you to tell the people out there just about some of the fighters you had a chance to work with over your time in boxing.
Oh, I got experience with the Indio Quintana when he fought Paul William at Helping Hand. Even he told me he has his own team, but he said, Rafi, I need your help. So I Helping Hand.
Who else did you work with?
I worked with Antonio Ramirez, Cañaseca. He fought La Cobrita Gonzalez. I helped Maurice Harris, too. And I helped Alcero, one of the greatest trainers. That's a Body Maker's head trainer and manager.
You said
New Jersey. I worked with him in New Jersey, New York.
At the Rocky Marciano gym, you told me, right?
Yeah, Rocky Marciano's gym. I met Rocky Marciano's brother, too, Lou Marciano.
Yeah, I've seen him before. You mentioned that you trained Carlos Quintana when he beat Paul Williams. What changes did you make to bring the best out of Carlos to win that fight?
I tell him to beat this guy, you have to catch his punches, you have to move in the angles to beat him, and working in your defense.
Yeah, and just so, as a trainer yourself, you worked with a lot of fighters. What's the number one thing you kind of do? What's the number one thing you do to kind of change the fighter and bring the best out of them?
Oh, I like to see in the beginning, because it's very important, you watch the guy, his footwork, how he move, you know. And from there you go, you watch him. The first time he come, you watch him how to do shadow boxing. From there you... And knowledge here in your mind, how you want to change the fight, how you can make it better.
Yeah, and you kind of, so you basically just watch the footwork and you kind of work off of that.
From there, yeah.
All right, so I know you worked around, you worked with Ishii Smith around 2013 when he captured the world title, is that correct?
Yeah, when he won the title, yeah.
Yeah, okay, you worked with him and who else? De'Leon Love?
Abuja, De'Leon Love, Alexis Santiago, Albert.
Madonna?
K.O. Bello. Madonna helping to do mitts with him when he fought Amir Khan.
Yeah, he fought really well that fight. Mm-hmm. That was one of his probably best fights, so you were part of, you know, arguably his
I
best
thought
fight.
He win the fight.
You thought he won?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought he won too. Anybody else that comes to mind?
Now, I'm working now with Ishii and Santiago. I think Ishii want to go fight for the world title soon. And Santiago too.
Okay.
Alexis. Ready?
Yeah.
More?
Hmm?
Sigue.
Mm-hmm. Can cash here? Cash? Cash?
Do it again.
Catch, catch. When you, some people fight a southpaw, you don't know how to fight a southpaw. When the guy throw a jab here, I just got covered here. And with the same hand, he come and tap with the hook, with the same hand, this hand.
Uh-huh.
Come and tap, yeah? I can block it right here. So, if he throw that one here, I can come this way. So this is where I combine my boxing with the Wing Chun.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, you're able to get the angles.
Yeah.
So you're
your angles.
And you get a free target. So it's really about the wasting as a little movement as possible.
Yeah, yeah.
Making things easier on yourself.
You're wasting a little, not too many energy.
Yeah.
You know, because the energy is there. You have to, you know, work it with the guy's body mechanic.
And how long did it take you to kind of like develop this?
Oh man, years.
Years.
I'm working in Puerto Rico. My first style was Kenpo Karate with Felix Rivera, mm-hmm. and then Ancheo Martinez, and then from there I went and trained Jishuan Kung Fu with one of the great masters. He trained in China with his master. The name is Oscar Cañal, and he teach my other teacher, Jose Martinez, a Jishuan Kung Fu.